Guoxi Zheng, he finds a new home here, and he signs with the Atlanta Hawks, 1 year, $4 million deal. So Zheng, last season, he played for the Memphis Grizzlies and the San Antonio Spurs, and last year, 6.8 points a game, 3.7 rebounds, 1.3 assists, 86% from the foul line, and 52% from the field. So Zheng, he's going to back up, most likely, John Collins if he re-signs, which I'm expecting him to. And obviously Clint Capella. So last season, Zheng, he upgraded his game a little bit, starting to shoot more threes. His free throw percentage went up 9%. And even his field goal percentage went up 7% from 2019-2020 to last season. But he's still not a player that's going to have fantasy value in Atlanta. And this Atlanta team, we saw it. They're a very deep team. And they got to the Eastern Conference Finals. So right here, he'll be probably the fourth or fifth guy off the bench for this Hawks team. And like I mentioned, the Hawks, they got a lot of good players on that roster. Trae Young, obviously, who signed to a max deal for $170 million. You got Bogdanovic, who came up second half. Clint Capella, John Collins, if he re-signs. Cam Reddish is over there as well. So a bunch of good players. Kevin Huerter as well, Gallinari. So right here, this Hawks team stacked. And Guoxi Zheng, it's a good veteran depth move here. But he's not going to have any fantasy value unless a lot of injuries. Or like I said, Collins leaves this roster and signs somewhere else here with his big contract. But right here, Guoxi Zheng signs with the Atlanta Hawks. And it's a good solid signing for a one-year deal for both parties here. He gets paid a good amount at $4 million for the veteran. And they get a good veteran to help these younger guys and play a decent role off the bench for the upcoming season.